Maybe one of those programs was turned on to sell this stock based on that high print, and they're going to just continue to sell it throughout the day, and that will continue to cap the stock. So again, it's for all time frames, it's all for all styles. Value investors who run the largest value funds can say, hey, I want to buy it while it's below the VWAP. Whereas as a momentum trader, that's the worst thing I can do is buy a stock below a daily volume weighted average price that's declining. But we all have different styles, approaches, and time frames. And the key is to pick little pieces here and there and say, how do I make my style better suited to me so that I can manage risk better, maximize my gains, make more money, and live less with less stress in the trade.
Absolutely. And so I was going to ask you also about the institutional, your chapter on institutional and algos and all that I found so interesting. So how did you get that insight, like about how the institutions do it? Because I know you're a chartered market technician and maybe you have some institutional experience or something, but like how did you get that insight of like how the institutions deal with VWAP and how they deal with clients? Because the clients, they kind of VWAP. So the origin of VWAP, from my under from what I understand, is it's the average price that a novice buys the stock. So if you buy below the novice, the price that a novice got it at, or theoretically got it at, then you executed the trade badly. That's the institution. So like their institutional clients, if they just see that like a statistic that they go by, kind of like a baseball card. When you flip it, it's like you look at the at batting average, but the batting average doesn't tell really the whole story. There's other things involved also. But the client is more or less novice or wants a quick understanding of what's going on. And if he sees the institution bought it at a below VWAP price, he's like, oh, I could have done that. Like, what am I hiring these guys for? So how did you get that insight of that? Is it through this experience or talking with other institutional people, or how did you get all that?
Yeah, a little bit of all the above. Realistically, I mean, I read a bunch of boring research papers about it, the way you dig into your 10Qs and go beyond what the typical small cap, short trader does is just like, hey, it looks like it's up a lot. Let's look for a place to short it today. You're more methodical in your approach. So I read all these boring research papers and kind of queued things together. And, the one thing that that I wrote about in there that you're aware of is, what Ken Griffin said about AMC and GameStop when he came in front of Congress, that he said, listen, we do the majority of trading in the United States. Our firm is responsible for more trading than any other firm. Then he went on to say most of that trading is algorithmic based, and those algos are generally based around the volume weighted average price. And he said, not just for one day, it could be a week, it could be a month, or even longer. So right there, the guy who made the most money ever in the market, which is the recent headlines, he said, this is how we're doing our algos. So, that kind of tells you, okay, it's clear. But I also spoke to, for instance, Tommy Thornton. He's on Twitter. I can't remember off the top of my head. I should know it. Hedge fund analysis or something like that. Anyways, he worked at a hedge fund that ran billions of dollars in Connecticut, one of the big firms, billions of dollars, and they were super active. They were doing hundreds of millions of shares per month. And I had some good conversations with him about, how sometimes his firm would set an algo, call up a firm and say, we want to buy, I'll just make this up, a half a million shares of Microsoft in the next 3 hours, at VWAP or better, and we don't want to do more than 5% of the volume during that time. So then they would adjust their little programs to make sure they do that. So it can get super intricate like that, or it can be a pension fund trying to build a position in a stock that just reported earnings and they want to buy it every single day for the next 90 trade, business days until the next quarter report comes out. So it came from, research. What I've seen on the tape and just looking at it going, it held that level again, and again from that event. And, just kind of the way we learn anything is just, digging in there, rolling up your sleeves, making trades around it and talking to people and realizing this is what's going on. It's not a fake, I always say on Twitter, No, must be another coincidence. It bounced right at that level. So it's the way the market moves. It's the objective supply. It's the only the true objective measurement of supply and demand.